Today we shall reflect on the theme, Led by the Lord. And we see that in today's world, it is very difficult to find someone or to find some leader who is dedicated and who works entirely for the interests of others. We see that most of the leaders tend to have their own vested interests in mind. But today, Jesus gives us a perfect example of one who is different because he cares and treats each one of us as his own. This is exactly the difference between the good shepherd and a shepherd who is hired. And therefore, we see that in the Old Testament, often God is portrayed as the shepherd of the people, and the Messiah is also shown as the shepherd of God's people. So in this way, we see that in God's hand, all of us are secure. And therefore, he invites us to place our trust and faith in him. A glance at today's first reading shows us that Jesus has become the cornerstone. Now, the cure of the lame beggar who stands with Peter and John gave Peter the opportunity in order to proclaim the word of God. And here, when he's speaking, he does not only intend to tell it directly to the Jewish authorities, but indeed, it is meant for each and every one, all those who are present there, and also for us listening to it today. And here we see that God has symbolically made Jesus as the cornerstone. As we all know, that the cornerstone is one that bears the weight and stress of the entire load. And here we see that Jesus is that cornerstone in our lives. And therefore, if Jesus is placed at the center, we know that Jesus will do everything for us. Our lives have to be focused and rooted in Jesus. And that is exactly what Peter, in the first reading, tells us. In the second reading, we see that each one of us is called in order to become children of God. John promises an unending life of intimacy with the Father, and this is possible only if we are rooted in Jesus and if we place our trust in him. And therefore he says that in this world we find a lot of incompatibility between the way of the world and the way of the kingdom. And most of us would have experienced it. Sometimes it becomes very difficult in order to follow the gospel values. But then John reminds us that all of us are children of God. And being children of God, automatically we are given the graces in order to deal with any challenges that can come on our way. But sometimes we are so occupied with the problems of the world, or sometimes we are so focused on ourselves that we fail to recognize the grace that God sends, sometimes directly or sometimes through other persons. A glance at today's gospel tells us that Jesus is the good shepherd and the guardian of our souls. And here we see that Jesus makes three promises. Firstly, he promised everlasting life. And this is possible only if we accept him and follow him. Jesus also promised a life that would have no end. Because for Jesus, death is not the end, but it is the beginning, and it is the beginning of a glory of indestructible life. And Jesus himself has shown us. He died for our sins. He laid down his life for us so that we may be saved from the slavery of sin and death. And finally, Jesus promises a life that is secure. If we place our trust in him, if we surrender ourselves to Jesus, we can be assured that no one and nothing can snatch us from this love of Jesus. And probably it would be good if we could ask ourselves this question. Do you listen to the voice of the Good Shepherd who calls you? Now we see that when Jesus spoke, his words would upset the Jewish authorities, because for them, they could not comprehend the fact that somebody who is as simple, as practical as Jesus could be the Son of God. Some thought that he was mad, and others thought that he was divine. And similarly, we see that each one of us in our lives have got the same choice. whether to accept Jesus or to reject Jesus. And one of the best gifts which God has given each and every one of us is that of the freedom. We have the freedom of choosing what we want. But at that time, we need to discern well in order to choose what is right and what is wrong. And all this, once again, comes by the grace of God. And so, in a very special way today, let us pray for this grace that we may develop this intimate relationship with Jesus so that by being rooted in Him, we too may be able to put up a brave face whenever we are faced with challenges in our lives. Amen.